In fluid mechanics in general, there is something about the balance between the fairly advanced math and the very simple conceptual visualizations of the flow. I think that balance is essential for understanding. So the schematics, if you have a flow of airfoil and some vortices, that's not a complete representation of the flow, but it grasps the main things. Developing that ability to show in a sketch the main things without actually drawing something that's not true, but omitting the unnecessary details is a good skill, right? So if you, it's not necessarily kind of learning outcome for this course, but keep an eye on it. And what I'm using is as kind of a not really an inspiration, but the echelon for this is this book. I have it as a reference. So this is Schlichting's boundary layer theory. It's a classic. People have made careers or became famous just for translating this book from German. But this book is full of schematics that are somewhat similar to the ones that I'm using in the course. So they're all black and white. If you have a chance, to take a look at how the book is laid out. So it has this simple black and white schematics that are excellent in terms of conveying only the necessary information. So when you start working with a more complicated fluid problems, I strongly encourage you to try to sketch them first, just to get a conceptual understanding. And then if your solution kind of contradicts drastically down the road of what you sketched initially, it's regardless of whether you were right or wrong to begin with, it's a good point to check whether you're still on the right track with the solution. So maybe your initial understanding was off. So yeah, that's kind of a general suggestion.